a raid was conducted, and DNA showed that there was at least 92 individual leopards in this guy's premises.
You can't contain leopards. They go wherever they want to go.
What we're doing today is that we've got a young male leopard. He's going to want to start expanding his territory at this age, and there is no space for him in this area. There's other big males, so he's going to land up where we don't know.
What's awesome about this collar is that if he leaves the reserve, we'll still be able to track his movements using the GPS and cell phone technology. We've been monitoring his movements for the last 3 months. Since leaving the reserve, he's covered over 200 kilometers heading north to Mozambique and then Swaziland. 2 weeks ago, we lost his signal. Leopards have already lost over 30% of their historical range. And where they do occur, they're at lower density. So we are sliding down the hill, the same hill that the tigers have followed.
Very thin wire.
We lose about 15% of our population each year to poaching. We've established that poachers are starting to target leopards. The question is, why?
A Shembe religion is approximately 5 million members. We need to have more skins because our church is growing every day.
There's about 300 to 400 leopards in KwaZulu-Natal, and here there's 1,000 leopards. So they must be coming from somewhere else.
20 kilometers on either side of that international boundary would have been completely cleared out of leopards.
Manje mase beyibulala bona bebe bona uthina singaba nazo manje uthwa uyahamba la ngaphandle uthola ukuthi abanye sebe namalawa amazwana angemnandi kahle kuwena wena osukusebenza la ngaphakathi bafune nani ukushaya yonke le ukuthi unqaba nenyamazana.
You can't just now start confiscating skins. It has been going on too long, so we're going to have to look at a different way in trying to solve this problem. It was looking into the younger generation that I came up with the idea of making fake skins, because they all have fake skins. So what I'm doing is I'm just taking pictures of all the fake ones and see what we can come up with impala or using a completely unnatural material.
It's very realistic. How much is it for the goat skin? For now, we've been kind of evicted from the property. Even though we're trying to do it in a peaceful manner, they seem to have started becoming defensive on that topic. So there is another way. I mean, most of these skins are illegal, so the law could be enforced here. I'm working with the fake leopard skins. I'm trying to make a fake one there. But there's different types that I see the people wearing. The one's got the tail that comes down the front, the ones that got the face. Which do the followers prefer?
Prefer lokumumsi.
We've just arrived at a local tailor in the Maduku community, and we're gonna go see if she can stitch these samples together for us. The first of them. The next step from here is how to make this look like this over here. This company is the only company in Africa with the machine that does four colors. So each individual thread, you can choose out of four different colors what should be put in each place. So we can then get these complex designs that we see on leopard skin. What we're doing here is we need to convert this real image into a digital image that the machine can recognize.
Select just our blacks and the resets.
It's very positive. We can get these skins made by July. They will implement them and introduce them and sell them at the gathering.
Really, we are afraid. If the leopards are getting finished, where will we go? But if you comes up with a new thing, it can replace the real one. And then we can put the other one, as long as it is beautiful.